Farmers should be free to choose what they want. And there are a lot of impressive, cheap, what are called agro-economic or agro-ecological solutions of ways of dealing in ways of where what you plant and what you plant next to something and how you deal with insects. Doesn't need to be that at all. And farmers want to do what's effective and what's cheap. Whether they're in Africa or Iowa or Australia, wherever, farmers are instinctively interested in that. So I would say what's important is to give them the range of opportunities. Because I worked in villages, starting back in the 1960s, and farming is really hard. And you put back-breaking labor, and most peasant farmers and underdeveloped countries, they live on the edge of survival. And 1 year, one bad crop, and you and your family can be finished. And so they're reluctant to change and are hesitant to do things because they want to do what's tried and true. And yet, they face these new threats of crops that they may have more flooding, they may have more drought, terrible issues that can finish off their crop, or pests that can come. So whatever tools there can be that are available to them and need to come from, you know, trusted sources. That's why the extension workers from universities are so important. Companies have sales representatives who will come and say, "This is, you ought to try this and do that." I mean, that's what happened in this country.